Hi guys, today we are going to begin a new module, and that is Indian English Literature. Indian English Literature is a very important module from NET point of view, and even in the revised syllabus you could see many questions being asked from Indian English Literature. In this video we are going to have an overview on how English literature or how Indian English literature developed and emerged in India. First thing is, what consists of or what is this Indian English literature? Indian English literature consists of the body of work by writers in India who write in the English language and whose native or co-native language could be one of the numerous languages of India. So when we say this is an Indian English literature, or when we say Indian English literature as a whole, it means it is about the writers who have the native language, whose native language is one of the many languages in India, but who writes in English. Okay, so that is what we call as Indian English literature. For example, if we consider the case of Rabindranath Tagore, his native language is is Bengali, but at the same time he writes in English. He also writes in English. Similarly, R.K. Narayan, whose native language is Tamil, but he also writes in English. So that is what we call as Indian English literature, about the writers in India who write in English language, but whose native or co-native language could be one of the numerous languages of India. And it also includes the work of members of the Indian diaspora who are of Indian descent. Okay, so for example, Indian English literature, or Indian, when we say Indian English writers, the people who belong to that group also include the diasporic writers, that is the writers who have their origin back in India but might have situated or might have migrated to some other areas, especially to England or other localities. So these are the two group of writers we refer to when we say Indian English writers. The writers who belong to India but might have migrated. It is not necessary that they migrated, it might be their forefathers who migrated, but if they have an Indian origin, we add them to Indian English group. History of English language and literature in India starts with the advent of East India Company. We all knew that how English came to India. English came to India with the East India Company. When East India Company came to India in the 17th century or in the early 1600s, they brought English with them. Okay, so it is through them that the language of English came to India. And you can see in when we learn the module Indian English, sorry, English in India, we have already mentioned about how the role of English in India, the role how English came to the academic circle of India, how English came to the elite group of India. So we discussed about it. So here we are going to have a look on the role of English in Indian English literature. Because English was the only language for the Indians to communicate with the East India Company, and therefore in order to get education, in order to get a good look from the East India Company, the Indians, the native Indians, they started to get English education. And also with the East India Company came the missionaries who wanted to convert the native superstitious beliefs or superstitious people of the India and they wanted to convert to Christianity. So in order to convert to Christianity, they have to learn English, because that is the only language through which they can communicate Christianity. And there are many other reasons for them to learn English and for the East India Company to teach English. And in the late 17th century, so the coming of the printing press. So with the advent of the printing press, or with the arrival of the printing press, many newspapers and journals also came into prominence. But the publication were largely confined to either printing Bible or government decrees, and therefore the printing press was confidentially English. And two main things that happened in 2 years which actually shaped the role of English in India is, in 1779, the first English newspaper, was published, which was named as Bengal Gazette. Okay, which was named as Bengal Gazette. The name is very important. That happened in the year 1779. And again in 1793, the first book in English literature, the first book in English was published by Sheikh Dean Mahomed. He published a book titled Travels of Dean Mahomed. It's a travelogue, it's a travel memoir, and you can see that these 2 years or these two publications actually shaped Indian English literature. In its early stages, the Indian writings in English were heavily influenced by the Western art form of the novel. Okay, so this 1700 or the beginning of 18th is actually the time when Britain was flourished with novels. Okay, or the genre of novels actually came into prominence in Britain, and you can see that Indian English literature was also heavily influenced by this Western art form of novel. So the writers, they were either Britishers or they were British educated people, and therefore their way of reading a text was British libraries or British literary works, and therefore they tried to adapt the Western literary style of a novel with English themes. They preferred to use English unadulterated by Indian words to express Indian thoughts, because learning English or knowing English was an act of status, and therefore they wanted English to be unadulterated by any native languages, and therefore they tried to use unadulterated English words in their works in order to express Indian thoughts. And you can see, as I said earlier, the writers were either Britishers or British educated Indians. And now moving to the writers in the early 20th century, you can see that a new breed of writers started to emerge on the block, and these writers, they were essentially British who were born or brought up in India. Okay, so these writers, they were not Indians, but they were essentially British, but because of their relation with East India Company, they were either born in India or they were brought up in India, because you know, in East India Company, hundreds of Britishers, they stayed in India. When they raised in their population, of course their offsprings, they were born and brought up in India, and that is the new breed of writers who emerged in the early 20th century, and they wrote about Indian themes and sentiments, but in a Western storytelling, because since they are not familiar with the native language or native culture, they couldn't get a hold of the native styles of writing. So they took the style of Western storytelling in order to convey Indian sentiments and Indian themes. And some examples of such writers are Rudyard Kipling, Jim Corbett and George Orwell. We have already learned about them in British literature. So they all have Indian relations. So these are the writers, and in their works you could see that Indian sentiments or Indian thought process can be seen in their works, and they have no reservation in using native words. In those periods, the natives, okay, so other than this early 20th century breed who were essentially British and who were born and brought up in India, there were other natives, and they were like, and their interest can be recognized in the works of Rabindranath Tagore and Sarojini Naidu. And in 1930, Tagore was awarded Nobel Prize for Literature, and that brought Indian English to the area of world literature, or that is how the importance or significance of Indian English came throughout the world. So that is about, so in the early 20th century, you could see the British writers and also the Indian writers like Rabindranath Tagore and Sarojini Naidu. And for other 3 decades, there were no specific writers, because it was a time of aspiration and reconstruction. People were actually especially Indians were quite in doubt whether to write in English or whether to write in their native language. And after all this reconstruction and chaos, then came the writers like Mulk Raj Anand, R.K. Narayan and Raja Rao. They contributed to the fiction from 1935 with Indian context and themes. In the works of Mulk Raj Anand, R.K. Narayan and Raja Rao, you can see that the themes are of Indian. It is about how Indian people are exploited by the Britishers or through capitalism. So it basically deals with the Indian caste system, Indian problems, and also the sentiments of the Indian people. It was in the late 70s that a new breed of convent boarding school educated and elite class of novelists. So when India got independence, there was a new culture developing in India where people gave their children British education, not in the sense the complete British oriented education, but English education, where they were brought up with all sort of discipline as an elite class. They were brought up as an elite class. They were convent breeding people, and they were Salman Rushdie, Vikram Seth, and Amitav Ghosh. And in their works, you could see the themes or the sentiments of people in the town areas or in the cities rather than in the village or in the marginal areas. In such type of writers, you could see the problems of the Mumbai life or problems of the town city life. And they are the Man Booker Prize winners, the Indians who have won the Man Booker Prize award. It is V.S. Naipaul for his work in A Free State, Salman Rushdie for Midnight Children, that's the most important work of Salman Rushdie, Arundhati Roy's The God of Small Things, Kiran Desai, The Inheritance of Lows, and Aravind Adiga, The White Tiger. Why I said The Midnight Children is important is because Midnight Children was awarded the Booker of Booker's Prize. That means the best among the Booker Prize winners, and also the best all-time prize winners in 1993 and 2008 to celebrate the 25th and 40th anniversary of Booker Prize. So that is why Salman Rushdie and the Midnight Children are very important. And recently you could see a new crop of authors like Pankaj Mishra, Chetan Bhagat, Jhumpa Lahiri and Hari Kunjuru, who have arrived on international scene, and their writings are also recognized worldwide or around the globe. So that is an overview of Indian English literature. So in this video, we have discussed about how English came to India, who were the first generation writers and who were the second generation writers, and the recent writers who were convent boarding elite group of people, and also the recent writers like Chetan Bhagat and Jhumpa Lahiri. So that's all about this video. Thank you.